Pentagon says the US soldier who dashed into North Korea is now listed as AWOL, or absent without leave. It remains unclear what the intentions of Travis King were for crossing the border.
North Korea has been silent about Army Private Travis King, who ran across the border into North Korea on Tuesday, and concerns are mounting. The U.S. Army Secretary made her first public comments about the case. Christine Worma said the U.S. has mobilized efforts to contact North Korea, including going through United Nations communication channels. Pyongyang has yet to respond. She cited the case of Otto Warmbier, the American college student who died in 2017 shortly after being released by North Korea. She said this, quote, "I worry about how they may treat him, so we want to get him back." Warmoth also said King's motive is unclear, but he, quote, "absolutely would have faced consequences for misconduct if he returned to the U.S. as planned." We also heard from the Pentagon. The Pentagon would not say if it believed Travis King was alive. Here's the Pentagon spokesperson.
The Army has launched an investigation into this incident. It's going to be led by Army counterintelligence personnel, and they'll be conducting this in coordination with U.S. Forces Korea. So at this moment right now, I can't tell you more about his whereabouts. That's something that the investigation would reveal.
The investigation will be in part looking at where King was between the time he left the airport and when he went on the tour when he crossed into North Korea. Ao Sing said King was not escorted onto his flight because he wasn't in custody when he was at the airport. His escorts weren't allowed to go beyond airport security. She also said that there was no inclination that King's crossing may have been planned with the North Koreans. Now, the Pentagon describes his formal status in the military as AWOL, or absent without leave. Now, this all comes at a time of high tension on the Korean Peninsula. On Wednesday, North Korea fired two short-range ballistic missiles just hours after a nuclear-capable U.S. submarine made its first port of call in South Korea in decades. And now Pyongyang has an American soldier in its custody and is not responding to any outreach from the U.S.